It's time. It's time to make a used to be video. And believe it or not, folks, do a motherfucking movie review. Yep. Used to be. Now, this is not going to be a horror movie review. We'll leave that to 40 Ounce Horror Show. This will not be a piece of dog shit movie review. Like fucking Mall Cop. Nope. We'll leave that bullshit to Joe Skull. No, this is what we're reviewing. Duel to the Death. Released in Hong Kong in 1983. It goes as follows. And I'll try not to be too long-winded about it. Used to be. Searching every day to find a better way. I've got a hustle still to get my pay before I hit the bottom. Now some might say that I'm already there. But who are they to judge or question what I do? So I don't care. Tired of eating cheese sandwiches with no meat. Tired of watching all the players from the same seat. So it's a life of crime. Some might sing around to escape again looking for the plan. The gist is basically this. Every 10 years, the Chinese put up their best swordsman, who this year happens to be Bo Ching Wan, who trained in the Shaolin Temple for 10 years, but he's not a Shaolin monk. He just trained there for 10 years, and he was also trained by this crazy-ass monk hermit-type dude that lives out in the forest. Anyway, that's who the Chinese put up, Bo Ching Wan. Choices to make, what am I gonna do? Gotta use my talents, they're gonna pull me through. Now with success, I become a target. They wanna set me up. I guess my money was no problem. They wanna get me wounded. Now the Japanese, of course, puts up their best samurai. Guy by the name of Hashimoto. They set the fight up, and Hashimoto heads for the Shaolin Temple. At which point, a bunch of crazy shit ensues. Used to be. And I can't take it. Now, to neither one of these guys' knowledge, there are some Chinese dudes collaborating with some Japanese dudes to steal some secrets from the Shaolin Temple, and a whole bunch of fuckery takes place. That's neither here nor there. Some might find some of the fight scenes cheesy, over the top, unbelievable, and yeah, a lot of them are. But I'm going to tell you why this is one of the great ones, folks. One of the absolute fucking great ones. Used to be. I was raised on these mean streets. You know, where poverty can help me. Brothers get jealous, life's for sale cheap. Since mama held me in her arms to tell me that it's a cold world, I've been hell heat. And held myself down, a lot of bodies and shells found. And niggas in the taking everything that ain't nailed down. We failed that, ain't hard to tell now. I ain't trying to see the cell now. I see mama put a house up for bail, man. So I'ma. Now. This came out in 83, so I'm not really worried about fucking spoilers.
I won't give everything away, though. Let's just say, before the final fight scene of the movie, they've discovered a few things. Found out they were being manipulated in certain types of ways. And Bo Ching Wan tells Hashimoto, fuck this fight. I'm not doing it. We were set up, cuh. Hashimoto understands all of this and sympathizes with Ching Wan. However, him being a fucking brutal-ass samurai, he ain't letting shit go. He came there to have a duel to the death to see who was the best, and that's exactly what the fuck Hashimoto intends to do. Used to be...
All I got to try and get that block. Nigga, I'm hot with this hustle. Go ahead and hit the dots. I use my talent to get more figures. Unlike these little corner stone niggas. Go change your drug.
Well, Ching Wan is still not with it. So he's like, fuck it, guy, I'm going home. At which point, Hashimoto jumps up and kills Ching Wan's master from the Shaolin Temple. Hashimoto gets his fight. And I'm here to tell you, folks, I have watched thousands of martial arts flicks in my life. Thousands of them. I've seen the fucking Donnie Yens. I've seen the fucking Tomisaburo Wakayamas. The swordplay at the end of this movie, though it's not technically the best, is probably the most brutal I've ever seen. Like I said, a lot of this movie you have to suspend your disbelief a little bit with, but it pays off at the end. It's 87 minutes long. It moves quick. Have some cabbage. Drink a 40 ounce. I guarantee you will enjoy it. Unless you're just a fucking retard who likes Paul Blart Mall Cop. Used to be.
Oh, niggas, now with success and I become a target. They wanna step me up, kick me hockey, or take me down some notches. They wanna hit me, wanna stick me, get me for my riches. They wanna diss me, wanna clip me, leave me stiffin' bitches. And I can't take it. Son, no game. No, my life ain't nothing to play with. Make it. Face it, one of these bad.
I do have one slight knock on the movie, though. And I think this is just because I'm an Asian cinema fucking nerd. Watched thousands of fucking martial arts flicks, kung fu flicks, fucking good anime. But in the movie, everybody's a Chinese guy. Even the Japanese guys. They're all played by Chinese people. Now, a lot of you might think, oh, gee, Vega, what's the fucking difference? They all look... Well, no, they don't all look alike. And when you've been looking at Asians as long as I've been looking at Asians, well, folks, you can tell the difference. Tell them, Larry. You know I know what I'm talking about. Swole, swole, swole. Stay tuned for the next movie review. It's going to be one that a lot of you are a lot more familiar with. Used to be.
A few rise, mini drop, two lies, semi's cock, this scale, the ready rock, heavy shots, heavy drop, new guys on every block, blue eyes and red dots, pregnant mothers, broke fathers, more money, more problems, so hungry, won't stop.